thrilled to have here on the Rich Eisen Show, Mr. Ron Perlman. Good to see you, Ron.
So good to be with you, man. So good to be with you.
You got it. So now you're a native New Yorker, right?
Native.
Born, raised, the whole bit, right?
Native, you know, with a rattle in my hand and necklaces and
and all that business?
I was a native.
So that means, so what was your team growing up?
New York Yankees.
Okay.
I was basically just a baseball guy. I mean, I've never been very good at multitasking, so I thought, you know, pick a sport. No, I mean, when I was like, I lived in Washington Heights, grew up in Washington Heights.
Right around the corner.
171st Street between Broadway and Fort Washington.
Mm-hmm.
My dad, when I was old enough to walk, we would go down to the 155th Street Bridge, cross over to the Bronx, walk up to 161st Street, and buy the cheapest tickets you could buy, because my old man, the biggest heart in the world, but he was really lower middle class.
Right.
And he died kind of young. I was 19, he was 49. So my way of maintaining the connection with him was Yankee Stadium.
So who was playing in Yankee Stadium?
I mean, Billy Crystal called it the cathedral. For me, it was really truly a religious experience, because it was this connection with all of the stuff that represented growing up in New York, and I happened to grow up in the 50s, so I saw from the first at bat to the last at bat of the great Mickey Mantle, and the Yogi Berra years, and the Muscarin years, and the Elston Howard years, and the Whitey Ford years.
Maris right in the middle of that,
Maris
61 season.
Maris comes in, shakes everything up a little bit. A lot of people were like, hey, man, what the hell is this guy doing stealing Mickey's thunder?
Isn't that incredible? He was losing his hair in that season.
And they were, you know, everybody was going, hey, he's hitting it to 230, you know, he's hitting it straight down the right field line. He's got no talent. Mickey, he's dead center field, man. That's a home run.
Yeah.
I mean, that was the discussion.
Back in the day, for
Back
sure.
Back in the day.
So now, and Ron Perlman here on the Rich Eisen Show, I asked you, so what do you, you know, I was going to ask you, what do you think Aaron Judge, 50 home runs rookie, and Gary Sanchez, and what's going on now? But you left them?
I walked away from the Yankees. And
why?
In walking away from the Yankees, I basically, you know, abandoned, well, I was never into the NBA or the NFL, strangely enough. I don't know why. I just
never were.
Like I said, I'm
so,
not
you
very
walk?
Good at multitasking.
Why'd you
I walked. The immediate cause of me walking away was the firing of Joe Torre. And then the secondary cause of me walking away was the raising of the great Yankee Stadium to build another stadium 20 feet away, which looked identical to it. The only difference being you could charge $200 more a ticket, which completely would have priced out my old man, guys like me, who there was no other way for us to have a connection to baseball that was intimate, that was in the stadium, if it weren't for the cheap seats. And, you know, the cynicism that goes along with having a team that, what, the payroll is, what, $160 million?
If no, it's more than that. But no,
well, I mean, the
saying.
Last time I checked, it was like, I haven't checked in a while. Like, Joe Torre hasn't been the manager in a while.
No, I know that.
But, you know, this is a guy who took a mediocre team and brought him to the playoffs every single year. And because he doesn't win a World Series, because the front office can't put together a great team, they blame him for not getting to the World Series. And when they fired Joe Torre, I said, you know, the cause and effect is gone. There's too much corporatization, too much meddling with the guys. And I understand meddling because, you know, I'm an actor and, you know, I have my own independent film studio, which I founded because of the meddling of the studio system. So, you know, I understand the juncture of corporate and the guys who fill the seats, which is under siege right now in a different kind of a way. This whole NFL conversation, taking a knee conversation.
Ron Perlman here on the Rich Eisen Show. So what are you into? Golf? We noticed you picked up a golf club. That's your sport?
Great swing, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think you were doing it for comedic effect by trying to brain my buddy Chris Brockman over there with a putt from about 20 feet away.
I would have sculled it. It would have gone between your legs.
That's the way you putt.
Yeah.
Texas wedge,
I'm the best sculler in the game, man. My wife says to me, how long have you been playing? I said, 30 years. She says, you suck. I go, yes, I do. She goes, why do you continue to put yourself in this position? I leaned on the putter and I looked at her and I said, listen to me. carefully, I said, just because a man loves something doesn't mean it has to love him back. And she said, you just saw that in From Here to Eternity last night. Monty Cliff says that about boxing. And I went, Jesus, she's watching my movies now.
She is, in fact.
I can't get away with nothing.
Well, it's a good thing that she didn't think you were referring to her, by the way. That would have been a,
that would have been a very difficult conversation
from there on in, Ron. Did you saw what Tiger Woods had to say in our news segment that we did about an hour ago? Do you think
continue to feel like as though he there's room for a comeback?
I hope. I don't think there is, but the fact that he's talking so freely and that he is talking so rationally about maybe it's not going to happen makes me think that a comeback can be born from that. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? That he thinks that it's if it's not that big of a deal, or at least he's putting that outwardly, that from that, of a clear-headed, sober point of view, I think it might happen. Who knows?
Was it? I'm sorry,
Brockman over there. What do you think?
Was it you that was saying if he comes back, it's the greatest.
It's one of the greatest sports comeback stories of all time. It's ripped from a Hollywood movie.
Not only that, but you know the trajectory that put him where he is right now is the stuff of like epic poetry. I mean, you know, this is like John Henry. This is like Casey at the bat. This was the guy who was two victories away from beating Sam Snead's all-time win record. And four victories away from doing the unthinkable, and then he gets caught sexting, mm-hmm. and that causes this chain of events that were not of his making. Kind of, it was like the universe. I mean, it was not of his athletic trajectory making. It's
correct.
It's a separate thing, and it caused him to have this almost like Greek drama reckoning with his fatal flaw and pay the price. So if he comes back from that, it's got all that other drama in it.
Yeah, his whole world crumbled and it was nothing that happened on the course. I mean, yes, his back kind of gave out, his knee kind of gave out, but all these other circumstances in a world that he created for himself crushed him and he's never been the same.
Yeah. I mean,
what do you think? Do you think there's a comeback in him?
I always like to think a guy who's got that kind of explosive, once-in-a-lifetime talent, you never can count him out. You can never count him out. I mean, let's face it. After all the initial stuff that took him down, which took him 3 or 4 years to come back from, he had a season where he won 5 times.
He was player of the year.
He was player of the year. And, you know, you're seeing that. Yeah, there's the back and the knee and everything else, but there's also this psychological thing that he's got to get past. I feel like he can. I don't know. I'm not a doctor, so I don't know how much of this is purely physical, that he never will have the body to hold up under that kind of pressure.
I guess when you hear him talk now, I wonder if he still wants that.
Well, I mean, the thing is that he's realizing. I just thought he sounded so clear-headed and so rational and so cool. That might be the spot from which he can make a comeback. That said, he's got people now who are truly half his age who can hit it 100 yards longer. So that's going to be, the physical aspect of it. That's
the other thing I wanted to say, is because I'm a voracious Tiger watcher, just like I was a voracious Mickey Mantle watcher, just like I was a voracious Muhammad Ali watcher, because these guys are rewriting history in their own way. They're in a class by themselves in their sport, or whatever their chosen thing is. Like Sinatra had it, you know, Dylan has it. But I waxed so poetically just now, I completely forgot what I was going to say. I should never have gone with the Sinatra thing. That's what Frank. You did it to me again, kid.
You're talking about Tiger, seriously. about being able to come back and that he's never lost it, or he had that sort of thing going on. But
where was I going with that?
I don't know. It's fantastic.
Can you have me back on again?
Do you want to answer
that? I'll remember it in the car going home.
Do you want to answer the poll question?
Where was I going with this? The poll question.
I don't know, but let's just get to the poll question because it involves Frank.
Okay.
So, we lost a great American last night, Ron.
Hugh Hefner.
Hugh Hefner at the age of 91. Whose life would you have rather had?
Well, I answered this on the way down.
Hugh Hefner, Wilt Chamberlain, or Frank Sinatra?
And when he added Sinatra, that's I said I have a weakness for blue eyes.
That's you.
And so
Francis,
you know,
Albert.
I mean, I love you, Wilt. Hef, I wish I could have hung out with you more or at all. But it's got to be blue eyes.
Before I let you go, Ron Perlman here on the Rich Eisen Show. Clay Morrow playing him in Sons of Anarchy. How much of a toll did that take on you? That was one real badass individual you played for such a long time.
It was really weird. I mean, I never really had to do much physical stuff as Clay, except pick up the bike that I had just dropped, because I set a record for dropping the bike while filming, to the point where when I would start the bike and I would get ready to pull out at the end of a shot, you know, after all the dialogue was over, with people would go, cut, 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 because they thought I was going to kill myself and others.
Yes.
And it was not a good idea. It would have shut the show down. But no, it was such an ensemble show. And there were so many other amazing go-to guys on the program that I never really remember breaking a sweat. I mean, I had a few great moments here and there, and certainly a presence. But it was very evenly doled out, and it was not one of the harder gigs.
Well, it was a lot of fun, and so many people fell in love with that show for sure, and they're kind of bummed it's not taking place anymore. But you got Crackle Startup right now that is in season two. You're part of it. You enjoy that? That's streaming today?
It's really, really cool show. And I would recommend, if you have the least curiosity to see my entrance into the second season, watch the first season, because it's some of the best television I've ever seen, and it was what drew me to wanting to be a part of the ensemble.
And the ensemble, including you and Martin Freeman, Adam Brody, just to name a couple. And loved having you on the show, Ron.
It's a pleasure to be here.
You got it.
I'm going to call in with this tiger thing,
you
this
got
train
it.
Of thought. I'll
you
remember it the minute I get up from this chair.
That's the way it works. Back.
That's the way it works. Yeah. That's the way it always works. We got the number. 844-204, which is the number for everyone else to dial. We'll take your phone calls and get you set for hour number three with Sean O'Hara. What is the best rivalry in the NFL? Right now I'm saying it's Ravens-Steelers, but we've got some other interesting ones that are on tap. Ron Perlman here on the Rich Eisen Show. Crackle Startup tonight. Actually can start streaming it right now on Crackle Season 2.
The Rich Eisen Show. Weekdays at noon Eastern on radio stations across the country and audience.
If you like that, download our app. Please, just if it's a memory thing, just delete other apps. You don't need those apps. This app, the Rich Eisen Show app, you need that.